So here with Nick, Bacash and Rebecca Joe Hanbury. Great new podcast you've got out here. I think it's a 10-point series. Tell us all about it, Nick and Rebecca, because I know it's doing well and it's trending.
Yeah, so it's called Babble Froth. It's a scripted comedy drama audio series that's set in a cafe. And essentially we're inviting audiences to be like a fly on the wall as they listen in on these diverse conversations that are happening episode to episode.
Great. Rebecca, so, I mean, these are kind of quite topical issues, aren't they? I know dating, social media, kind of some of the content. I mean, that's probably why it's popular. We like to talk about these issues, don't we? And like to spend our life kind of gossiping.
That's right. Well, I think we're all missing out on eavesdropping at a cafe and sort of catching up with friends. And it's been a whole year of, you know, not being able to do that. So, and not a great deal happening. We haven't had a lot to talk about. So, yeah, it's been nice to sort of write sort of interesting, sort of sometimes
very diverse,
salacious, yeah. Funny scenes, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, what gave you the inspiration? Because podcasts, I mean, I'm quite into my podcast now, and it's kind of a really good way of interacting, isn't it, to get kind of getting content, really, because you get rid of the adverts for a start, which is always a good thing, and you can just go straight to the material. And in comedy, it seems to work.
Yeah, it really does. I think audio now as a platform is massive, and we really started listening to podcasts at the beginning of lockdown, didn't we? We really started getting into them as a bit of escapism, being able to go for that hour walk and listen to something or learn something or have a bit of a laugh.
And
when it came to us sort of deciding what we were going to do with our time, 2020 was going to be our year, wasn't it? We'd written some pilots.
It was going to be amazing.
It was going to be great. We'd written some pilots. We were pitching. We were all geared up. We were going to do a play.
Yeah. And then the pandemic happened.
We all got locked down.
It's sort of, we had to reevaluate, and that's where the podcast idea came from, really.
What can we do from home?
Yeah.
Basically, and who's available and how are we going to do this? So we were going to do them all ourselves, weren't we? We were going to play all the characters. And we thought that might be a bit greedy. So we reached out to some friends and put it on some sort of platforms. And yeah, we've got a heap of
some really good callbacks.
Great actors. So
why the title? So where's the title come from? Babble Froth. Where'd that come from?
So originally it was called The Coffee House. And we just were like, nah, it's got to be something a bit more interesting, a bit more dynamic. Yeah. And we just got the dictionary out, the thesaurus, and we were just throwing out ideas out there because we wanted it to be quite eye-catching, have a cool flow to the name itself, and sort of babble because obviously the conversational side of it, and then froth because it's a cafe. So it just sort of felt natural, really, when we were sort of counting.
So did you get some new inspiration from earwig and about what other listening into other conversation? Because I don't know about you, but if you're on your own in a coffee shop, I do sometimes listen in and it's fascinating. Sometimes you can't help it, but I mean, is that where you've got the inspiration from as well?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, we like the fly on the wall aspect of things, like you were mentioning. It's fascinating what's going on out there, and there's so many wonderful conversations, and it's amazing what you can fit in. You know, when sort of one of the ideas was sort of 10 minutes, keep them quite short.
Keep them short.
You know, it was amazing what you can kind of fit in and how you can get to the kind of crux of a conversation quite quickly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what are the other topics? I know dating, social media, what other topics are you covering in a 10-point series?
We threw in a pandemic.
I didn't want to, but we're like,
We've got a mother and son. So that's always an interesting dynamic.
Yeah.
Lots of friends, lots of sort of friendship, new friendship. We've got a scene about a thruple. If you don't know what that is, I mean, Google that.
Listen to it. The consensual adultery, it's called. That was fun to write.
Yeah.
Smorgasbord of just interesting stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it's, like you were saying, that there's so many funny, interesting conversations that happen potentially in cafes.
Yeah.
We just wanted to explore all of them.
And a cafe is so neutral. Anyone goes to a cafe, you know, any age person goes to a cafe. It's kind of quite diverse. So we could, We couldn't have done it in a bar, for example.
Could have been different.
Yeah, it would have been different podcast.
So what are the characters? You don't play yourselves then. What are the characters that you introduced into the podcast?
They're all completely different. So right. Every episode is a completely new story with new characters and new actors.
Right, great.
15 actors altogether.
And how do you access it? How do people get involved? How they download it?
So listening wise, we're on all the major platforms, so Apple Podcasts, Spotify, yeah. Amazon. And acting wise, yeah, I mean, we were interested in sort of talking to everyone. Mm. Initially when we started, because it's a new podcast, it's for those people who have done a lot of acting or voiceover work or whatever, there was a little bit of convincing because it was them taking a little bit of a risk. But now that we're out there and people are seeing that it's doing quite well. We've had a bit of interest actually from other actors and stuff. So, but we're always on the lookout for voice yeah. actors and actors generally. So definitely get in touch.
Yeah. I mean, do you edit this at home then? Cause I've just done an interview previously about someone who's edited a whole kind of feature length documentary from home. She's learned it from scratch actually. And yeah. One thing we found running TV companies, you can do a lot of interviews you can do via Zoom and you can basically have a TV studio in your kitchen. Have you done all that editing yourself, and how do you get to the best bits? Do you throw away a lot of material to get to the cream?
Yeah. We do about 3 good takes.
Yeah.
Right.
Obviously we do all our rehearsals and things over Zoom, and it's, you know, coordinating with everyone. We've got, you know, parents involved, so it's coordinating time. Sometimes we're recording at 10 o'clock at night, sometimes it's 8 o'clock in the morning, we're all over the place. But it's just getting 2 or 3 really good takes and then editing it down.
Yeah, and everyone has different kind of audio setups, so
yeah,
it was just working through that and just trying to clean up as much as we possibly could to get, you know, the best kind of listening experience possible. Mm.
Yeah, exactly. We were just having a discussion about podcasts before we did the interview. I mean, sound quality is key to podcasts, isn't it? Obviously, because there's no visual. So that is quite key, isn't it? And I mean, I'm sure you're finding that as well. So are you going to do another kind of series after this? It sounds that you are. It's going to be a long running thing, really, this work.
Yeah, I think that, you know, we're just starting, really. I mean, there's a lot we want to do with it. You know, we'd love to do a theatre run potentially in Edinburgh.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a few little ideas running around with pitching it for TV as well. So there's definitely, we feel like it has a bit of legs, and there's still so much to explore with it in terms of conversations.
Yeah, I think it'd be nice to develop it full screen and have them as, you know, just sort of short little episodes that you can dip in and out of. It's not sort of, you know, in any sort of order. So, you know, whatever you episode you fancy, you can just sort of dip in and out. I think it would be a fun,
yeah, it would be really good fun.
Yeah, and just before we go, I mean, where do you find a time to kind of get creative? Is it, have you found it easier during lockdown, or have you found it harder? Because obviously, a lot of people, they're all under the same roof. It's kind of difficult to find your own personal space to get your thinking cap on.
Yeah, it's a great question, mate. We no, really, because it, you know, there are moments when you're a bit like, oh. But then it's like, you know, we had a goal, and we, you know, we wanted to be fair with each other to make sure that we both had time in the room to do our writing mm. and then to do the rehearsals and the editing and then everything else. So we found a way, and luckily the kids are pretty good. They're not that demanding. So
yeah, we took it in turns.
We took it in turns.
Lots of snacks.
Yeah.
Involved.
Peppa Pig.
Yeah. It was a bit of that.
Yeah.
Brilliant. All right. So once again, so it's Babble and Froth, and people just get your normal kind of podcast platforms. They can go and access it, can't they? And and you can get and all the episodes are up there. We can access all the episodes in one go. Brilliant.
Yeah. Right. Social as well. Yeah.
And on social media, we're on all social media. If you want to see the actors' faces,
see
what they look like. Brilliant. Okay. Nick and Rebecca, thanks for joining us. All the best. We'll catch up again soon. Cheers.
Thanks.
Take care.
Thanks.
Cheers,
guys.
Bye.
Bye.